Hi friends, and welcome back. Welcome to another installment of our training videos for serving in the special needs ministry. My name is Greg McDougall. I'm the Director of Special Needs Ministries at Woodside Bible Church. We're glad you tuned in today. This video's topic is some broad definitions of special needs and disability etiquette. A lot of this stuff isn't rocket science, it's more common sense. So this won't be that deep, and a lot of it will be things that will be pretty reasonable to you, I would assume. One of the things I think we can assume with people with special needs is they're different and they're individual and they're unique, just like anybody else is. One of the things for when we talk about broad definitions of disability, it's good to know maybe the background or medical definitions of cerebral palsy or Down syndrome or autism or Rett syndrome or any other kind of special need, but don't define that person by that disability. There's an adage that says that if you've met one person with autism, you've met one person with autism. You can't assume that this person with autism does this or has this kind of personality than all of them are. They're not. So, but it's good to know broad definitions. In your volunteer packet, you should have some broad definitions of what Down syndrome is, what autism is. We're not really going to cover that a lot, only other to say that it's good to know why and what that disability is and maybe how it plays a role in their personality. But really, we want to minister to the individual and we don't want to minister to the disability. That's what we don't want to get hooked up on, is the individual is the person we're ministering to and not the special need. So with that said, there are some do's and don'ts when we talk disability etiquette. The biggest one is to just treat these people as people. And again, with any kind of respect that you would anybody else, you would not talk down to anybody else. So don't talk down to these people. You would treat these people at their age appropriate level. In other words, if there is an adult with a special need, and maybe somebody says, well, their mind is an equivalent to a third grader, you're not going to treat them as a third grader. You should treat them as a person, as an adult. And that's what we want to do. We want to treat them as an adult. We want to talk straight to them and not to a caregiver, not to a parent. If we want any communication with them, it should be directly with them. Those are some things to start out with. Another thing too is and this is real simple, people tend to be wanting to help others. And we want to do that with our friends with special needs. However, it's polite to ask first, can I get the food for you? Can I take this from you? Would it be all right if I did this for you? That way you're including them in the process of decision making and giving them more respect. Be sensitive about physical contact. Not everybody likes physical contact, whether they have a special need or not. So be sensitive to that they might not want to be touched on the shoulder. Certainly don't pat them on the head, and that's really patronizing. And we don't want to do that either. When working with somebody with a visual impairment, allow them to maybe take your elbow or take your arm to help guide them to the table or to another area of the room. We want to be conscious of them and their space. It's okay if you don't understand what somebody is saying to ask them to repeat it. And another thing we do verbally sometimes is we try to finish sentences for them, or we don't allow them to finish a sentence because we're in a hurry. Let them finish their thought. Let them process what it is they want to say and listen to them. And another thing too is when we're communicating back to them, understand that they might not process in the same speed that you and I might. It might take them a couple of minutes to process what we just said or what we want to do. So that's another thing that we want to do. Some things we don't want to do. We don't want to lean on somebody's wheelchair. That wheelchair is really a part of who they are. That's their identity, as if it were their leg or their arm. So we don't want to do that. We don't want to use baby talk. we don't want to use words like crippled or handicapped or golly, when I grew up, the term retarded was used all the time. We want to use respectful terms. We want to refer to the person as the person and not the disability. In other words, the person with autism rather than the autistic person. It just puts that person first and it respects that person as an individual. Again, if we're communicating and we're communicating to them, we look directly at them. A lot of this, friends, like I say, it's just common decency that you would treat anybody else with. And really the bottom line in this video is that's how we want to treat our friends with disabilities, just like we would with certain understanding, but just like we would anybody else. Thanks for tuning in, friends, and God bless you.